This is obviously the most important test for the year, especially for the 24-hour, because we're going to basically use this weekend to simulate the race. And our number one goal is to get all the drivers through the car, make sure everybody's working together, do a lot of work with tires, and then of course with this weather to figure out what we're going to do if we come back here at the 24-hour and have these conditions. But I would say the main thing is just getting everybody up to speed and giving everybody time in the car. You know, Pedro drove for us here last year, so he's had some good time in the car. Ricky's done a little bit of mileage in the car this year in Indianapolis, but you know, he certainly needs time. And then of course myself, having not driven, and then of course Max will do what he normally does. But really it's just to get a feel for the race and make sure that everything is working well, driver changes and so on and so forth.
You know, one of the really cool deals about the Rolex 24 is the test days. We have a great time coming and doing this, but it's also time we can shake down all the, you know, all the bugs of the new cars, the old cars, and really get all the drivers acclimated to sharing one car, one platform, one setup. And it's not always easy. You know, the best teams out here are the ones that do learn how to get to that point real quickly. They can share, you know, obviously we're sitting different guys are different heights, different weights, different everything, and having to arrive at one setup on the car that they all agree on and they share and they are able to participate in that the whole weekend. That's a key and that's difficult, and we try to do our best to help them.
We approach this test just like we do the race. We just try and get the drivers through, get the drivers comfortable, and really just work on race pace and comfort level. Look at reliability, you know, check parts out, you know, to make sure we don't have no issues when we come back for the race.
Well, we just have so many new moving parts this season, going from one car to four cars, a lot of new drivers, a lot of new crew, new trailers, new equipment. So what we're really trying to do this weekend is get all the components tested, get the drivers up to speed, get the cars up to speed, new crew, new procedures. There's just a lot to do. And I mean, we really made it difficult on ourselves going from one GT car to four cars, two in each class. And it's actually been hard for me because I've had to kind of redelegate my role from being more involved in the car to now just being more involved in everything. But from a car standpoint, the GT cars, a lot of new components to try, new bodies, new downforce, new drivers, another new kind of engine campaign. And then, you know, for the GS cars, this is really the first time the cars have been out running on a big track like this. We ran them at VIR and another new car for that. So, you know, Daytona is such an important race for all of us, you know, in GT and in GS, and we want to have the best results we possibly can in both cars. So we have a lot of work to do because you want to be perfect at the first race. There's really not much time to kind of build up from there.
Basically, for today, Friday for sure, we're using it for bedding in things. So brakes, brake pads, ring and pinions, some gearbox things. That's the primary focus today. So we didn't worry a lot about track time. The weather's not cooperating too much with us anyways, so that's okay. Then the next 2 days will be primarily for the guys that are going to be here part-time to get used to our car. They've been driving other cars, and they're all a little bit different. So it's just getting everyone familiar with the cars. We're comfortable that our setup is a top kind of three, top five setup. The cars are really good right now. So it's more familiarization and doing some driver change stuff and that type of thing.